40 in this area. I've run out of ways to comfort the school and to comfort families. Here am I again, not visiting a school to check academic progress, not visiting the school to determine whether the teachers are teaching, not here to check if learners are doing well or not, but to prepare the school to accept death, and also to prepare learners to accept death, and to also come and pick up a soul that was supposed to be a professional person in life, but now we have to prepare that soul to go to a gravesite. The school gave me a full report of what happened. They indicated that it was after the second period, just around half past nine. They indicated that the learner looked sick. Actually, was sick. He was coming back
yesterday.
And on the basis of changing of periods, they leave the classroom per rows. And then he was on the second row. And then when he left, when the teacher was concentrating on the third row, the teacher heard screams from learners. The principal was also around. They knew those screams were not ordinary screams of learners playing. This was unique. And unfortunately, when they arrived on the scene, the learner fell, and they called paramedics and everyone, the family as well. And the learner was taken and rushed to hospital, where he unfortunately left us. It's difficult, you know, it is as if it's a message that is directed to me personally. Because the name of my daughter is still with me, and the learner that passed on here, the name is still with me as well. So it's like it's reaching at home to me now.